Before we start talking about analytical methods for solving second-order differential equations, I think I should first talk about a numerical method for solving higher-order ODEs, which is basically just a generalization of the Euler method that we used for solving first-order ODEs. So let's consider a second-order ODE. I'm going to introduce a new notation here that comes actually all the way back to Newton, which is the dot notation for the derivative. So x double dot here means d squared x dt squared. X dot would mean dx dt. You only use the dot derivative when you're talking about the derivative with respect to time of your variable. And basically, it's going all the way back to Newton's equation when he invented calculus. So I very much like to use this notation. So the second order equation can be written in some general form where we have the second derivative of x is equal to some function, which could be anything, that depends on the independent variable, t. It depends on x, and it depends on the first derivative of x, which I write here as x dot. So this is the general second order equation for x, which is a function of time. How do you solve the second order equation numerically? The idea is that you write it as a system of two first order equations. And then we'll apply Euler's method to the first order equations. So how do you write a second equation as a system of two first order equations? Well, first you say that x dot is equal to, define a new variable u. You know, going back to Newton, x would be position, u would be velocity. So x dot equals u, and then x double dot is u dot. So x double dot then becomes u dot. And then that will be a function of time, a function of x, and a function of x dot. But here x dot is u. Okay? So we got our system of two first order equations. We're going to need initial conditions to solve this. For a second order equation, you need two initial conditions. Here, for the two first order equations, we see that we'll need some initial condition, t naught, say, x of t naught is some initial value x naught. And then the other initial condition is on x dot, but here x dot is just u, so we can say the other initial condition is u of t naught equals u naught, okay? In Newton's application of Newton's equation, that would be the initial position and the initial velocity. Okay, how do we solve this? Using Euler method. The idea is that we need to solve both x and u simultaneously using the Euler method for the first order equation. So I think the easiest way to see how to do that is to draw two graphs. So let me draw the first graph here. Will be x versus t. And the second graph here will be u versus t. Okay? What do we have? We have initial values. So we know the initial value of x at t naught. We can put t naught equal to 0. That would be fine. So let's say that x is initially positive when t equals 0. So we have some initial value. I can put it here. And then we have the initial value of the velocity, say. That could also be positive or negative. So let's assume that it is 0, maybe. Well, 0 maybe is too special. So we'll assume it's small. We can put it down here. OK, doesn't matter. And then after we have the initial condition, we make use of the differential equation. So the differential equation for x tells us that the slope of the tangent line to the curve here at t equals 0 is given by u. But we actually know the value of u here. U is small, so that the slope here is positive but small, so it looks something like this, right? And then what does the u equation tell us? The u equation tells us the slope is going to be f at t equals 0, x equals x naught, and u equals u naught. So whatever the value of this f function is, and that could be anything. So let's say the slope is positive and increasing, so something like this. Okay? So this slope here is equal to u naught, and this slope here is equal to f of t equals 0, x equals x naught, u equals u naught. Okay? That's what the differential equation tells us. Euler method says then we step along the direction of the slope, of the direction of this arrow, the tangent to the solution curve. So we take a step, so we go here, we take a step, and we go here. And then this step here will be our delta t, right? We step the solution delta t. So what is the formula here? So this would be this value here would be the next value, right? So that's our x1, right? This is our x0. And this value here, that would be our u1. This is our u0. Okay? So the solution is rather straightforward. We get x1 equals x0 plus delta t times the slope. Right? And then we get u1 equals u0 plus delta t times s slope, which will be f of 0 x0 u0. Okay, so then we've taken our one Euler step. The trick here is that the Euler step has to be done on both equations at the same step. So to go from 0 to delta t, we need to increment both x and u, the second equation. Then x1 and u1 becomes our new initial conditions, and we repeat the process. Okay. So we see using Euler method, we can solve any general second order differential equation as a system of two first order equations. And you can generalize this to third order equations or fourth order equations. Or say if you're doing the problem of planetary motions, you may have three second order equations, and you can write that as six first order equations. And to integrate that, you would do all six simultaneously. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next video.